So yeah, Mark of the Beast, vaccine, end time prophecies. Does this have anything to do with anything? All this and more. Hey guys, my name is Brother Mario. Welcome back to this channel. If you are brand new, welcome. If you have never been here, the purpose of this channel is I'm here to show you that we are real apostolics with real problems, with real solutions, all solved in a divine way. And if that's something that vibes with you, make sure that you subscribe to this channel, hit bell notifications so you know exactly when I post a video. And if at the end of this video you like this video, well, go ahead and hit that like button. That does help the algorithm to make this video more viewed. But with no further ado, let's get into the question. And I have to give a shout out to I have to give a shout out to Marjorie Batalla for putting this question. And she says, hello there. I know this is a very sensitive question, but can you also give insight about the vaccine? If it is the mark of the beast, 666, if so, would you still want to get vaccinated? That is a loaded question. And I am so excited to get into this video because I think this is a question that a lot of apostolics, a lot of Christian believers have been wondering, is the vaccine the mark of the beast? Now, when you kind of get into this and you start talking about the vaccine and really how it was kind of poorly presented, you can't help but to think about it. Like, I've thought about it. I would be lying to you all if I said I didn't think about the vaccine is the mark of the beast. And the reason why I thought of it is just like, well, look what's happening in this world. There's deaths happening, there's a pestilence happening, and Jesus talked about that in the end times there would be rumors of war, earthquakes, pestilence, and this happens to be one of them. And, you know, people are mandated to wear masks, which, you know, just, I don't want to talk about masks because they don't work. But anyways, that's neither here nor there. You hear about Bitcoin on the rise and you just kind of wonder, like, am I going to get a mark on my hand anytime soon? Like, it gets you thinking, like, are we living in the end times as Jesus spoke about? Now, what's funny is I've gotten the vaccine before for the flu and I've never flinched. I've never second guessed it. I never thought anything of it. It was just the flu vaccine, right? But this particular vaccine, I was hesitant, right? And as of recording this video, January 17th, I still have not gotten the vaccine. But it's because how it was kind of presented to you. Like, I feel like the government was selling you on it. Like, you had to be convinced to take this. And I remember even hearing about in legislations that they were thinking about paying the American people to take this vaccine, which was like mind-blowing. I was like, when have we ever in history had to be paid to take a vaccine? It was like, okay, if the vaccine does what it's supposed to do, like, why are you selling it, right? Why wouldn't people just naturally come to it? Well, it's because of the big, you know, trust factor that, or I should say lack thereof, between us and the government now because how they handled this thing. So yeah, that just really didn't sit well with me. And so as we dive deeper into this video, I'm gonna be explaining about the mark of the beast in context, which I always tell you all is very, very important that we do read this in the Bible. And again, I'm not an expert in Revelation. This is solely my opinion. And like I said, I haven't got the vaccine until this point. So is the vaccine the mark of the beast? We need to get into Revelations chapter 13, verse 15 through 17 goes like this. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, and the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. That's the key. Mark in the right hand or in their foreheads. And that no man might buy or sell, save that he had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. I read this in a commentary of a pastor, and he said, when it comes to the mark of the beast, it may not be a literal mark on our skin, forehead, or right hand, or anything like that, but more likely, it may be an abstract mark, meaning it could be a devotion to something. It could be an allegiance to the enemy. That's probably what the mark of the beast is going to read. But again, Revelations is an extremely complicated book. A lot of words and descriptions in the book of Revelations are not meant to be taken in literal context. Mark of the beast could or could not be one of them. So now that we know a little bit of foundation of where we find the mark of the beast, we really need to dive even further to understand, is the vaccine the mark of the beast? And the only way to do that is we need to determine if Revelation happens in a chronological order, okay? And if that is the case, we know the mark of the beast happens in chapter 13, but there is an event that happens in chapter 8 that is extremely important, called the rapture. And here's what the rapture is. The rapture is an event where Jesus Christ will appear in the air, the trumpet will sound, and all believers in Christ will leave this planet. Those who have died since the resurrection of Christ receive their resurrected bodies. Those that are alive will also be changed in the twinkling of an eye and depart from this world. The most vivid description of this event that is going to take place is 1 Thessalonians 4:16 through 18. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. So what this event does, it essentially takes away the church, right? And after this event, the church will no longer be here. Meaning, if you and I are believers of Jesus Christ, we've been baptized in Jesus' name, received the gift of the Holy Ghost, have walked in a holy, repented lifestyle away from this world, then you and I will actually not be on the earth when that time comes. We'll be taken up in the rapture. So when you break up the book of Revelations, it kind of breaks up into the revelation of heaven and the warning to the seven churches. Then there's the rapture that takes place, the tribulation period, and then finally the new heaven and the new earth. And again, to remind you, we find the mark of the beast in Revelations 13. The rapture happens in chapter 8. If the book of Revelations happens in chronological order, as I understand it to happen as, that means the church will no longer be here. So if you and I are here watching this video, that means the rapture hasn't taken place yet. And that means the mark of the beast will happen during that 3.5 year tribulation period, which means this: the vaccine for that thing, I'm not going to mention on this channel because I promised myself I would not do it in 2021, but the vaccine for that thing could not be the mark of the beast, as the rapture has not yet happened as of recording this video, January 17th, 2021. Which means you and I can breathe that if you elect to take the vaccine, you are in no way going in allegiance to the enemy. It's just another vaccine. It is totally your call if you want to take it. That is between you and your pastor and your parents, and your spouse, whatever the case may be. I'm not going to be the one to tell you, yes, you need to take it. Yes, you don't need to take it. But as for me, ooh, that one hurt. But as for me, I'm probably going to pass up on it. But I hope y'all have enjoyed this video. I hope this has cleared up some answers. So if you're an apostolic Christian, have no fear. I don't think this has nothing to do with the mark of the beast. If you take it, you're totally fine. That's for your safety, your decision to do that. So if you enjoyed this video, if these answered some questions, make sure that you share this on your social medias, tag a friend, send a link, read the description down below. Whatever you want to do after this video, I'd really appreciate it, because everything helps, and we are going to grow this channel to show the world that we are real apostolics, real problems, real solutions, all solved in a divine way. My name is Brother Mario. Have a blessed day. Peace.